Right, so let's start with some algebra questions. Let's say you've already done it before, so let's just recap. Right? So in a fraction, if I just say this, which one is the numerator, which one is the denominator? Numerator, denominator, right? Okay, so when you call algebraic fractions, either the numerator or the denominator will be a letter. Will be a letter that's representing any number. Okay, so let me just check your knowledge. I want to see whether you know how to add and subtract fractions, regular fractions. Okay? So can you just quickly do this in your book? I want to check your knowledge whether you can add or subtract regular this is something you should already know. Very basic idea of subtracting. Very basic one. Okay, so here that you already know how to add and subtract fraction. So now let's add a letter in. Okay, how would you do this? Because denominators are the same, you just add the top part. How do you add the top part? What is the first word? 2n plus 2. 4, right? You know how to do basic algebra. No, okay. It's not hard at all. You know how to do basic fraction, you know basic algebra. Just combine them together. So since the denominators are the same, that's the rule when you have to add and subtract fraction. Since the denominators are the same, we just add them. Okay? No need to do any of them. The answer for this will be 4x over. Okay, and let's try this. X over 30. Good. So these are very basic since we don't have to change the denominator. We denominator is already the same. So a lot of what you're going to get in the local syllabus is denominator is already going to be the same. And at this level, of course, when you go to your 10 and go to O level, the actual class, you're going to get five. But at this level, most of the time, the denominator is going to be the same. Okay? So, however, since I know in your electoral syllabus you have already done fractions where the denominators are different, so I'm going to give you some with different denominators. Okay, thank you.
Two students are
there.
So the one
is my
life.
Alright, so first, what's the LCM between 4 and 6? What's the LCM between 4 and 6? LCM. Is it? Is it 24? 12. See, I gave it as 2 over 6. Right? 2 over 6. Now, this is 2 over 6. First, you can, there are two things you can do here. You can simplify it and write it as x over 3. You could have written this as x over 3 and then done the LCM. That would have been faster. But let's say you couldn't simplify. Still, how do you find the LCM between 4 and 6? Shortcut method is just multiplying. That's what most people do. But the thing is, it doesn't always give you the LCM. Although, it's not wrong to do that. Let's say, okay, I'm going to do it both ways. I'm going to do it with 24 and I'm going to do it with 12. Okay, so let's say we did it in 24. So what does this become? Yeah, 6x. This one? 8x. So then you'll get 14x over 24. Alright, so here you have to simplify at the end. Here you have to simplify at the end. Then you'll get 7 over 12. But let's say you did it this way. If you do it this way, you'll notice you will directly get that answer. You won't have to do the extra multiplication at the end. So it's not wrong if you do it this way. However, get used to this. Alright? Get used to identifying the actual LCM. LCM means lowest common multiple. This is just the common multiple, not the lowest. Alright? So if you take 12 as the LCM, you get 3x plus 4. Which you get 7x. Right? The same answer but shorter. Any question? Okay, how do you simplify something like this? Sorry? 5 minus 2 over? Is that correct, Mohit? Sure? No, I'm not sure. Is that correct? 100% sure. 100% sure. Why not?
Yeah.
100%. Okay. It is correct. You see, I'm just trying to break it out, but And it reversed. You are not sure of your answer, even though this is the exact same thing. You doubted yourself because I questioned. You should be confident, right? This is the exact same thing, no different. Don't let me or anybody else create doubt. You should be confident enough to know the answer, right? So this is the same thing because the denominators are the same. So it's a common denominator. You write that down and you just subtract what's at the top. Okay? That's 3 over n minus 1. Okay, so do not get confused if denominator looks different, numerator looks different. The concepts are always the same. They will try to trick you in the exam with more different looking questions, but the concept never change. Alright? Okay, so here from a direct look, denominator is going to look the same. But in actual fact, they are. If you multiply out the bracket here, you get the same denominator, correct? So a plus 4. Alright, so now we have the same denominator, we just do the exact same thing. No difference. So 5 plus 3 is 8. 8 over 2a plus 4. Now, is this the final answer? No, that's the tricky part or the extra part. You have to simplify. Now, can I just cut like this? No. What do I do first? Factor. When you are simplifying within fractions, always factorize first. Okay? Always factorize first. Okay, so what's common in the denominator? What's common in the denominator? 2. Alright? And then what should I put? A plus 2. Now what can I cut? A and 2. A common? Sure. Now we can cut what's outside the bracket. Now again, can I do this? Why not? Because it's inside the bracket and there is a plus sign in between the numbers. When there is a plus or a minus sign in between numbers, you can't just cut them individually. Either you cut the whole thing or you can't cut at all. However, when there is a number outside the bracket, that means there's a multiplication sign in between. And in that case, when there's a multiplication sign between, then you can cut. Then also you can multiplication or division, you can cut. Whenever there's an addition or a subtraction sign, you cannot cut. Okay? Okay, so here we can cut only these. So what does this become? This? 4 over a plus. Any question? Sure? This is actually easier than your extra one because since you can't use the calculator, they can't give you too hard things. So, it's almost simplification. And that's done, it's what we did in there. Okay, we can do these two questions. We'll move on to the next chapter. Alright, so both of you made the common mistake. Okay, so now here the denominator are the same, first question, right? Denominators are the same, so there is no need to do anything about LCM. That part is done. Now the tricky part here is the minus sign. Now this minus sign belongs to the whole fraction, right? So that means when you write them down together, do not forget to put bracket, or else you will go wrong. Now there are two ways to go about this, right? You can multiply the brackets and then write it again, or you can just use the bracket as it is, the minus sign as it is. So you can do this. You can say 5x minus 2x is 3. And same time, 3 minus minus 1. What do you do when it's minus minus? You have to add. You can just say it to yourself and write it down, no problem. Or you can multiply out the bracket with the minus sign. Now, when I say multiply out with the minus sign, I mean multiply out with minus 1. Right? There's no number there, it means there's a 1. So let's multiply it out with that. So then it becomes 5x plus 3. Minus 1 into 2x is? Minus 1 times 2x, come on. You need to calculate it? Is minus 2x, okay? Minus 1 times minus 1? Plus 1. So then you can write it like that. You can rewrite it like that, and then now simplify it. Yeah. Then same thing for the second. So over here, again, denominators are the same even though I wrote them differently. So first you write the denominators as it is. Alright. So now, did I miss something? What? And then the bracket, right? You always have to write the bracket. Either you multiply it out in your head and write it down first, or put the bracket. I recommend you use the bracket, not say. But when in exam conditions, you miss out small things like this, very easy to make these mistakes. So always have a step by step method. And I recommend write down the bracket first without multiplying. Now multiply out the brackets, you'll get minus 3a plus 2. Now you get what? Two a minus 3a from. Two a minus 3a from. Minus 5a.
Minus 1.
Minus 1? 2 minus 3 is how much? Minus 8 or minus 1, right? Okay, then 1 plus 2 is? Plus 2. Yeah, then. Your final answer. You have to know there is no calculator, so you have to be very careful. Sometimes even easy questions like this, you make mistakes. So they're used to using the calculator. So even when you do a Excel sum, get a habit of not using the calculator for small calculators. Since you have the name of the okay, so this is basically it for algebraic fraction. Next week, I'll prepare some exam questions. I'm not just this topic, from basically all the topics that you have done. Right? For an exam, I'll give you the exam question. So you can get a feel of how the data is going. Right? Let's move on to volume. Any questions? Sure? Okay, on the left tube, right? Right? I can make a tube in the tube. They are made up of several 2D objects. For example, a cube is made up of many squares, right? Many squares pushed together. A triangular prism is made up of many triangles, right? A cylinder is made up of many circles. So all these regular prisms, they are made up of 2D objects. So the formula to find the volume, okay? To find the volume of a prism is area of cross section multiplied by the length or the height. Yeah. So in this case, how do you find the area of a square?
Square.
Yeah. Square. Area of a square. Length into width. Breadth. Alright. So this is 4. How much is this? It is 4. Why? How much? Why? Why is it 4? Because it's a cube. Cube is a square, right? Square means all four sides are
equal.
Therefore, if I give you one length, you should automatically know that the other length is 4. So what's this length? Three? Yeah. See? Again, I put doubt in you and you can see. You change the answer. So they're all four because it's a cube, right? They're all sides are made up of squares and squares have the same length. So in this case, to find the volume, it's area of the cross section, which is area of the square, 4 times 4. And what is the length here?
4.
So therefore, in this, the volume is just 4 cube. 4 into 4 into 4. Okay? Alright. So let me just test your knowledge on how to find the area for different 2D objects. Then we can move on to that. So we can, so I know you know how to find the area of the cross section. Right? Can you copy it down? right? No, why is there a problem? Why didn't you get a problem? The next experience. Okay. So to find the volume of regular prism, you need to know how to find the area of various 2D shapes. Okay? So a lot of these are basic, you should be knowing, but I will quickly go through them anyway. Alright, so let's take a square, you know. Rectangle. If this is breadth and this is length, what's the area of the rectangle? Be into that, right? Okay. Area of a triangle?
Half
into, base into, right. What about L? You don't do anything with that? So it's just this? Sure? Yeah, I just put the L there. You don't need that length to find the area of a triangle. Just use the base and the height. The center. So, how do you find the pi times b? Green is correct.
What?
Is correct. Area of
trapezium.
A plus B
into
X. A plus B into X divided by 2. Correct? Under it? Sure. Okay, last time, are you sure? Good. Okay, so these are the basic shapes you need to know. Triangle, square, rectangle, circle. Okay, so now what if they complicate matters a little, alright? These you know, right? You don't have to copy. Okay, right? What if they change it up a little? What if they give you a square, okay? With a hole cut in. Okay? And a square with a circular hole cut. So now this is your shape. Only the shaded part, that's the shape, remain. Okay, the length here are 4. This one is 2. Okay, now copy this down and find the area of the shaded part. pilot and two of them. And that will give the answer in terms of pilot. Either that or give the answer in terms of pilot. Hey, is that family or business? Yeah. All right. Are you guys done with it? So, all right, that's okay. Yeah. Okay, so here to find the area of a shape where they have already cut something out, okay, the shaded area in this case. In these cases, it's always the area of the total shape minus the part that you don't want. Okay? Okay, remember that as a general formula or a general rule. It's always whenever you want to find shaded area or a piece of the area, this shaded part, the shape alone, we don't know the formula for that shape, right? It's an irregular shape, it's a weird shape, it looks like this. Just this part, right? If you think about it, there's no way to find the area of that shape directly. Okay? So, we find the area of the big shape. What is the big shape? What is the shape? The square. The big shape here, the total shape is a square. How do you find the area of a square? 4 into 4. So, area of square equals 4 into 4. Now, what's the area of the shape that we don't want? The circle, right? So how do you find the area of a circle? Pi into r squared. So you can either write pi as 22 over 7 or leave it as pi. This chapter will leave it as pi, right? So what's the radius of the circle? 1, right? Remember diameter is 2, radius is 1. So pi into 1 square, which equals to 5. Alright, so now what's the area of the shaded shape? So area of shaded region equals to 16 minus pi or 5 minus 16? 16 minus pi equals total shape minus smaller shape. So the answer is 16 minus. Okay? So if they give you a volume with that shape, with the shape as a cross section, you should be able to find the volume. Right? Any questions? No? One of them? Okay, we go on. Okay. Okay, so the height here is 8, this is x, this is 10, this is 12. Okay? First part is find x. Second part, find the area. Area of cross section. Third part is find the volume. Okay, draw the diagram.
not finished, you can take a break.
problem with it? Use the pen. As your teacher was telling me, because my boys and girls learn they said they have to be a female or something. That's why teacher was telling me. In case you want. Okay, so the first part was to find x. How do we do that? Pythagoras theorem. This is the right angle, triangle. So, x, 8, and 10. So, what's the Pythagoras theorem? There are many ways of saying it. Let's take this one. Right? A plus a square plus b square equals. So, which side is c square? Hypotenuse, right? Always the longest side or the side opposite to the right angle, we take that as c. Therefore, we have a square plus x square equals to 10 square, right? So, here we use algebra to solve. Yeah. 6 theta, 10, 3, 4, 5. But it's okay to memorize that, but all is not clear. Right? So the first part is done. Find x, which is 6. You both got 6? Okay. So what's the next part? Find the area of the cross section. So what shape is the cross section? Triangle. How do you find the area of a triangle?
Half is the base.
What's the base here?
6.
Height is?
8.
So here you can cut to 3 and 6. Sorry, the 6 and the 2. You get 3. 3 times 8 is how much? Yeah, what about that? What did you say? X was wrong. Okay, so then the last part, find the volume of the shape. Now how do we find the volume of a shape like this? Cross section into length. So what's the area of the cross section? And the length is? Length is 12. So directly the answer is 12 times 20. Remember, you can't use calculator. You need to use calculator. Okay. So you can do it either mentally or by hand.
Ask
them what.
They use calculator.
Come for the check. I can't bother checking like that. International checking like that. So it's 288. Okay? If you want to do it in your head fast, you can think 12 into 12 is how much? 144, right? And times 2. That will give you 288. Right? Even though I did an extra tutor, I did a local tutor, I always practice without that. Most of my sums I didn't matter. I studied electrical as well, same school as the same as the day. Thank you. Okay, done? Not hard, right? Concept is always the same, concept will never change. Okay, let's try some more questions. Okay, so I'm gonna write the whole question down so that the people in Sri Lanka can also do the question. Then they can see the paper. Okay, try. I'll read out the question for the on Sri Lanka, in case you can't read my handwriting. A prism with a square cross-section has other faces in the shape of rectangle. That means the cross-section is a square, but the other faces are rectangle. Alright? The perimeter of the square is 32, while the perimeter of each rectangle is 40 centimeters. So the first part of the question is to sketch the prism. Okay? You can label each corner as a letter, that will make it easier for you. For example, make it like A, B, C, D for the square, just to make it easier for yourself. Part two is find the length of the square. Find the length of one of the length of the square. Right? One side. Part three is find the length of the prism. So the whole prism, there's a length, right? Area of cross section and the length. So you'll find that length. Part 4, find the volume of the prism. I found the length of the square. That's for the sketch, right? They said cross section is square, right? So means the middle has to be a square. All other sides are rectangle. Right? So this is the square. Every other side is rectangle. Now what do they say? Perimeter of the square equals 32. Perimeter is 32, right? So they ask you to find the length of the square. So now all the sides of a square are equal. So if I name one side as x, right? Every other side has to be x, isn't it? Because all the sides are equal. So therefore that means perimeter means what? What does perimeter mean? Addition. Exactly. Addition or total of all the sides of any shape. So any shape when you ask the perimeter is always the total or the addition of all the sides. So in this case it's x plus x plus x plus x, correct? So the perimeter is x plus x plus x plus x equals how much? 30. Right? Equals 30. So the perimeter equals to 30. So like you said, this equals to 4x. So how do I find x? I bring 4 the other side. Therefore one side of the square is 8. Okay? Alright. So part 2 was what? Find the length of the prism. Square is found. Found the square. And next one is prism. So length of the prism is which part in the diagram? This one?
Yeah.
This one? This one? This one? This one? All of these, right? This, 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 and this. So how do I find that? Now we know this length, right? This is 8. This is also 8. Okay? So we want to find this. And we know that the perimeter of the rectangle is 40, right?
40 minus
8
divided by
2, 1.15. Yes, that is correct. But in simplified way, I'm going to say, let's put this as y. We use x, right? Let's use y. So we use the unknown side as y. So if this is y, what is this?
Y.
It's also y, right? Because in a rectangle, opposite sides are equal. These two sides are equal, these two sides are equal. So they're both y. So perimeter equals 40, correct? That means if I add 8 plus y, it should equal to 40. So then simplify and solve this equation. But in the end it comes down to what Andre said. So the length of the prism equals to 12. Now the final question was what? Find the volume. So how do you find the volume of the shape?
Yeah.
Remember some question, when they say height, they actually mean the length. Those two words can be interchanged. And the height or length. Sometimes they say cross-section area into height. But they mean the same thing for long height. Because if you shift the prism like this, then long part becomes the height, right? So sometimes they say height, sometimes they use length. Don't get confused, understand the question or look at the diagram and find out what they mean. Okay? So in our case we are saying length. Right? So what's the cross sectional area? 8 times 8, right? Area of square. 64, correct? So area of the prism. Volume of prism equals 64 times 12. Is it? Yeah. Any questions? Go ahead. You know what you're doing? How do you need
to? Most of the time we can store, we have a little bit, we don't have any, so we can have a little bit more, we have a little bit more.
And what we can do is all day, do it every day more Okay, so I'll read the question. The height of a prism with an equilateral cross section, equilateral triangle.
Equilateral triangle.
The height of a prism with an equilateral triangle cross section of area 42.5 cm² is 15.2 cm. Okay? Find the volume of the prism. So this is the way the actual question is, but it's worded in a way to confuse. Alright? The height of a prism, then there's a comma. Height of a prism, then they give you some other information, then they say it's 15.2. So, forget about the middle part and just know that the height of the prism is 15.2. What's in the middle is extra information. Okay? So the height of the prism is 15.2 cm. They say with an equilateral triangle cross section. and area 42.5. This is a triangular prism, an equilateral triangular prism, that means the sides are equal, and the height of the prism is 15.2. Okay? So in this case, when they say the height, they actually mean the length. Alright? This is why I want to give the question. Two reasons I want to give this question is they interchange the word height and length. Other one is this word is confusing. It's very confusing word. Okay? So now we have a triangular prism. Right, it's an equilateral triangle with an area of 42.5 and the length of the prism is 15.2. Now we just have to find the volume of the prism. But this is something difficult to do in your head. Couple of questions for homework, copy them down. with the question. Prism has a rectangular cross section length of 30 centimeters and the perimeter is 1 meter. So of this rectangular cross section, the length is 30 centimeters, the perimeter is 1 meter. Right? Of the cross section. Now when they say the length of the cross section is 30 centimeters, does that mean the length of the prism? They're two different things, right? Don't get confused. The length of the cross section is this part. Right? But the length of the prism is this part, right? They're two different things. They're using the same words, but be careful. Okay. So the question is find the breadth of the cross section, find the area of the cross section. And they say if the length of the prism is 50 centimeters, find the volume. And lastly, if the mass of 1 centimeter cube is 20 grams, find the mass of the entire. Okay, that's part of the interpretation. Today it's over and coming. And this practice will be a little bit crashing down. All the comparison of the symbols that are present. Okay? Yeah. Then you can also learn asking him about what should I do, what should I do, what should I do, and also they will overlap in the next topic. Maybe just so next week we'll be a bit more intensive on polygons, and then after you come, we can start the workshop. Okay? Good luck. Thank you.